We're so special.
Was a fool, nothing that you shared, you could. So I'm gonna live like my shame is done. Won't be shackled to the way I was. I'm gonna live like my shame's gone, gone. Now my sin is dead and gone, and I sing hallelujah. Done, done,
So this morning, while we take communion, I felt during the week that God just really wanted to remind us of how much He really loves us. And while we were doing the soap, God really spoke to me through John 17. It's an incredibly long passage, but it's when Jesus is praying before He gets crucified. And He's really just pleading on our behalf and saying what He's done for us here and what He's accomplished here on earth before He goes and before He's seated at the right hand of the Father. And what stood out to me there was, there's a verse that says, may they experience such perfect unity that the world will know that You sent Me and that You love them as much as You love Me. And Jesus, I thank You that this sacrifice that You've got, that You did for us, is for complete unity with You and the Father and the Holy Spirit. You've given us this Holy Spirit to walk with us, to teach us, to guide us. And Jesus, You have never left. Your blood shed for everything, for every sickness, for every fear, for every sin, for every thought we battle, for every emotion that is not in line with the cross. So Jesus, I thank You for this blood. I thank You for Your body that was shed for us. I thank You that because of that, we are in perfect unity with You and the Father and the Holy Spirit. We get to walk in that every day for eternity. May we never take what You did lightly. May we never forget the sacrifice that You made. So as we take the body, Jesus, we thank You for what You did on the cross. We thank You for Your body that was broken for us. Yeah, Jesus, and I thank You for Your blood that was shed. I thank You that we are forgiven, that we walk in freedom, that we are no longer sinners, that we are free because of You. In Jesus' name, amen.
Enter Your courts with praise and thanksgiving. And so as we come into this place of being the Holy of Holies, we come in with thankful hearts, grateful hearts for what You've done for us. You are greater than all, Jesus. There's no one like You. You are greater, more powerful, more beautiful, more wonderful than anything in this world and in the heavens. There is none like You, Jesus. Thank You for who You are. Thank You that the Bible is full of testimony of graves turning into gardens and beauty for ashes and bones into armies and seas into highways. Thank You that everything that we read is a testimony of what You have done and the prophecy for what is to come. And so we come in with thankful and grateful hearts. we fix our eyes on you, Jesus, the author and perfecter of it all. I fix my eyes upon the cross. I'm reaching out with all I've got. I'm letting go to start again. I need your love, that's why I'm here. Waiting outside my life, it calls.
Yes, Jesus, I thank you that this morning you drew us so deep in. I thank you, Jesus, that you are so present in every situation, in this time where we're all so feeling a little tender about what's going on around us. Lord Jesus, I thank you that we can come into your presence, and that is where we are made whole, where our hope is restored. We give you our hearts, Jesus. We give you our soul. And that's where we want to forever be. We love you, Jesus. Amen. So we're going to switch over now to the preach. Ray is preaching for us this morning. So I'm just going to pray for you, Ray. And yeah, I pray that you'll all be blessed through this message. Jesus, I thank you for Ray. I thank you for the word that you've put on his heart. I pray that the words that he speaks will be your words. Holy Spirit, come and rest on him now as he preaches. And I pray that our hearts will receive what you want us to hear this morning. We love you, Jesus. Amen.